हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम काजली सरकार फ्रॉम आदर्श विद्या मंदिर शंकर विद्यापीठ माउंट आबू। टुडे वी विल स्टडी अबाउट अशोक, वन ऑफ द ग्रेट रूलर ऑफ आर इंडियन हिस्ट्री, हु गेव अप वॉर फॉर ऑलवेज। नाउ इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल रीड अबाउट द रीजन एंड ऑरिजिन ऑफ द एम्पायर, दैट इज अशोका मौर्य डायनेस्टी, एंड डिफाइन अबाउट चंद्रगुप्त मौर्य एंड हिज एम्पायर, relate the expansion plan of emperor and the extension of empire, describe about great Ashok and about Kalinga war, list the preaching and learning that Ashoka inscribed on his rock edict. So we'll understand this chapter with the help of the smart board, and this chapter I have taken from class 6 NCERT history, it is chapter 7. Okay, so let's start.
Origin of Mauryan Empire. Mauryan Empire was founded by great Chandragupta Maurya more than 2300 years ago. Only the family members of Chandragupta were the rulers one after another. Thus, it was called Mauryan Dynasty. The Buddhist text Mahavamsa calls that Chandragupta was a scion of Kshatriya clan named Maurya or Maurya. Thus, it got the name of the dynasty, Chalukya Kautilya. Every Chandragupta was assisted by one wise man named Chalukya or Kautilya. We get many information of the era from Chalukya's book named Arthashastra. There are many valuable lessons in this book which are still relevant in our present societies and about human lives. Extent of the Mauryan Empire during Chandragupta Maurya. The empire was spread along vast areas in present-day North and Western India during Chandragupta's reign. The capital was Pataliputra, present-day Patna in Bihar. Takshila was the gateway of the Northwest, including Central Asia. Ujjain was laid on the route from North to South India. Many merchants, craftspersons and other emperor officials probably in this city. The empire was big and vast, so in different parts, people used to speak in different languages and their culture was also different. In Central India, people used to live in forests and hunted animals for their food. There were farmers and herders too in the villages. Most interestingly, from Central India, the dynasty in Pataliputra got many elephants for the uses of royals and for their military forces too. Mauryan Empire and their strategies. The concept of kingdom and empire. Empires were basically larger than the kingdoms. The emperors needed a strong and huge army to protect his vast land. Thus, in this era, it was found in various places that different kingdoms were included under the rule of a big empire. Strategies and mechanism. In Arthashastra, it was written that the Northwest was famous for blankets and the southern parts were for gold and other precious stones. Emperor used to keep many officials to collect the revenues, taxes and other tributes on regular basis from people. By the aid of spy and messengers, the emperor used to reign his empire. The royal family members were selected to be the rulers of different points of the empire like Takshila and Ujjain. Megasthenes accounts about the emperor. Megasthenes was an ambassador who was sent to the court of Chandragupta by the Greek ruler of West Asia named Seleucus Nicator. Indica, Latin Indica, is an account of Mauryan India by Megasthenes. He described that the king led a very splendid life in his beautiful palace. According to him, Chandragupta was an autocrat and he was the master of unlimited powers. He kept himself fully aware of the main events of his empire through his spies. About Pataliputra, he narrated that the city had 570 towers and 64 gates. Ashoka and Kalinga War. Ashoka, a unique ruler. Ashoka was the grandson of Chandragupta Maurya. His father's name was Bindusara. Ashoka expanded Chandragupta's empire and reigned over a realm that stretched from present-day Afghanistan in the west to Bangladesh in the east. It covered the entire Indian subcontinent except for parts of present-day Tamil Nadu, Karnataka and Kerala. Chanda Ashoka, Ashoka the Fierce. Buddhist legends state that Ashoka was bad-tempered and of a wicked nature. Ashoka involved a bloody battle with his brothers in order to get the throne after death of his father. This earned him the name of Chanda Ashoka, meaning Ashoka the Fierce in Sanskrit. Kalinga War and its destruction. Ashoka fought a bloody battle against Kalinga 8 years after he became king. Legend says that one day, after the war was over, Ashoka ventured out to roam the city, and everywhere around him were burnt houses and scattered corpses. The lethal war with Kalinga transformed the vengeful emperor Ashoka to a stable and peaceful emperor, and thus he became a patron of Buddhism. Ashoka wrote about the Kalinga War in one of the rock edict as about 1.5 lakh people were captured and more than 1 lakh of people were killed. This filled me with sorrow. That is why I am sad and have decided to observe Dharma and to teach others about it as well. I believe that winning people over through Dharma is much better than conquering them through force. Ashoka's Dhamma and his rock edicts. What is Dhamma? Ashoka did not want to preach any specific religion or practice. He wanted to create a higher level of individual and collective morality and spiritual honesty among his subjects. The word Dhamma was derived from the Sanskrit word Dharma. A king for his people, welfare for the society. Ashoka took the titles Devana Priya, which means the beloved of the gods, and Priyadarshi, as it means one who regards everyone amiably. He saw several customs were followed in different regions of his empire. He wanted to teach his subjects about the evilness of those rituals and practices. He taught them so that they could behave properly to their servants and slaves, not to quarrel with their neighbors and give respect to other religions. Ashoka sent the messengers and Dhamma Mahamata to spread ideas and about Dhamma to other lands such as Syria, Egypt, Greece and Sri Lanka. The Mahamata explained the meaning of the inscriptions to the ordinary people. He built roads, dug wells and built rest houses. Besides, he arranged for medical treatment for both human beings and animals. Ashoka pillar or line column. The pillars of Ashoka are a series of columns erected and inscribed with edicts by the Mauryan king Ashoka during his reign. The group of four lines and bell jointly symbolize preaching of the four noble truths of Buddhism to all.
Well, students, you understand, hope you understand well this chapter with the help of this smart board. In our next video, we'll show something else. Till then, thank you.